Hello and welcome back to Star Wars The Old Republic. Well, I've just been sitting here and wore a hole through this chair. Had to come and get someone to repair it, but of course they charged double because I wouldn't get out of the chair for them to repair it. So you had to work underneath it. Basically, they had to remove the entire bottom of the ship here to repair it. It just took a long, long, long time also. But at least I got my good sitting in, you know. West rest of those legs. And I found this glitch also that allows me to spin in place in the chair and put my legs, speaking of them, into it. Like this. You know, just like that. There. There. Don't try this at home. Okay, don't try that at home. Alright, let's move on, shall we? I realized that last episode we spent the entire episode doing nothing. So let's try not to do it this time. C2N2, sorry. You have a lot of hit points for a pacifist.
Every time I see you return from a mission, I thank the Maker I wasn't designed for combat.
Dude, I haven't even returned from a mission, alright? Really? I mean, seriously? Are you kidding me, droid? Really? Were you programmed to say that? Did I program you to say that? Did Scavic program you to say that? Yeah. Yeah, don't say anything. Okay, this is a Culto tank, just in case you're wondering and thinking that this is a Bacta tank. It's not, it's a Culto tank. It is supposedly really helpful to swim in a tank full of stuff. Also, amazingly, it is possible to inhale it, I would assume. Somehow, it actually helps the lungs to inhale the stuff. I've heard. At least, I have to assume, because you see people all the time swimming in this stuff and being healed, so. Yeah, I guess so. Where's Corsa, by the way? What? Hold on. Hold on! This droid can do it too? This droid can also do this stuff? But I wouldn't want him to, because Corso's the only one that's good at it. Right? I mean, Corso just owns. But, companion C2N2's not so good at the... Or is he? Wait, what? Oh no, he should be just as good. Right? Hold on. I thought this was his effectiveness. No, this is the effectiveness of all the companions, including companions C2N2. So I can just have him just go ahead and do this stuff, right? Yeah, no problem. Medwatch, healing increased. You know, if you're good at healing, right? I mean, you can heal me up. I'll just bring you with me, let Corsa do his thing, and you can heal me up, right? Right, C2N2? I'll try and take the hits for you, alright? If you get hit, I mean, you've got hit points, alright? And you've got increased healing. You'll be fine, droid. You can rejuvenate somehow. Does that make sense? He's a droid. He can rejuvenate. Okay. Don't stare the bugs in the face, alright? Read the Minecraft flash screen thing. Don't stare bugs directly in the face. Alright, I'm paraphrasing, of course. Basically, I'm flagged for PvP. How? How's that? What did I do, huh? How am I green? What happened? Oh, I'm in a flashpoint, technically. I'm in one of those places. I'm instanced to something. Something about that. Oh, okay. Have I managed to waste 10 minutes already? Well, I'm afraid we're gonna have to end the episode here. I'm kidding. We're gonna get something done, alright? The last episode, we got nothing done. Like, I mean, we did, but, you know, it's after doing nothing. I mean, what? We didn't. Okay. Risha?
I'm taking a wild guess that my life just got a new kind of complicated.
Is this the, is this what Bazakanstan brought me? Got me? Really? You're on my ship. Wow. Oh, no, no, no. Oh. Oh, you're probably one of Skavik's slaves. Oh, okay. Well, hello, gorgeous.
Funny, I don't remember leaving a beautiful woman in my cargo hold. Must be my lucky day.
Depends on your definition of lucky. My name's Risha. I've been traveling with Skavik as part of a business arrangement. He and I had a deal to deliver the things you see here.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I've seen some of these. I made some of my own. It's fine. I understand. You won't mind if I unfreeze this guy, though. You know, he might be someone I can... that can be my companion, you know?
You call this cargo? You picked a bad partner. But I don't care, because you're gorgeous.
Now I'm all ears. Keep talking.
Skavik was going to deliver this cargo, but he's proving unreliable. I think you might be a much better partner.
You think?
Hey, I do trust you. And I don't want you to pack up and go. Welcome to the ship's crew.
Let's hear your offer and we'll see.
My offer is simple. I make you filthy rich. It's a pretty straightforward business model.
Hey, maybe you didn't notice I'm already filthy rich?
I know. That's Skavik on the ship's hollow. This should be an interesting conversation.
I think I accidentally advanced my class story.
You're late, Skavik. And I just made a new friend. I think you two will loathe each other.
Congratulations, Captain. You're officially number one on my list of people to kill. When I get my hands on you, you'll wish you never left Ord Mantell.
Well, I'm number one on your to kill list? Well, how about that? How about that? We ought to play dice. We ought to play some box sometime, because I'm, you know, you're actually number one on my hit kill list too. How about that, Skavik? Small world, huh? Small galaxy, isn't it?
Eat my exhaust, pal.
Best of luck. Yeah, ready when you are, Skat. That's the one I'm going with.
Come and get me anytime you want.
You can bet on it, and I guarantee you won't see me coming. I don't know how you got away from those Imperials, but next time, I'll kill you myself. Assuming Rogan the Butcher doesn't get you first. I sold all those blasters you were supposed to deliver for him on Ord Mantell. I can't imagine he'll be happy that he lost them.
What? What'd you do? You sold all those blasters? Yeah, Rogan the Butcher, he don't scare me. Bring it on, Rogan the Butcher. Bring it on, Darth Malik. Darth Malgus. Bring it on, Skavik. And anyway, he knows the truth. So, yeah.
I'll make sure Rogan hears who really fouled things up for him.
I'm sure you'll have lots to say while Rogan tortures you to death.
Are you done posturing, Skavik? The captain and I have cargo to deliver.
Don't even think about cutting me out of this deal, Risha.
Finders keepers. Isn't that what you always say? Not my fault the captain here beat you to the big prize.
Sweetheart, you two just made the biggest mistake of your lives.
Mistakes. Mistakes, sir.
Thought that blowhard would never switch off. So, we were discussing how I can make you fabulously wealthy.
And I was telling you how I'm already fabulously wealthy.
The items here are pieces to a key. A key that unlocks the lost treasure of a very rich dead man named Nocturne.
Okay, it's all very fine and good, sweetheart, but I have work to do, alright? It's called killing Rat Ghoul. Maybe you'll come along, maybe I'll bring you along with me, assuming that you're fit for combat. And, yeah, Corso, he'll just be, off collecting some, conveniently, he'll be off collecting some, oh yeah, he'll be doing one of those missions, underworld trading. That's what he does. He does underworld trading. We wouldn't like him. We got something. We got a greater plan. Knock Dre. We're gonna take him down or something. Oh no, he already got taken down. Okay. Okay, Richa. Risha, alright. Rich, huh?
Now you're speaking my language.
Just wait. It gets better. Nocturne was the greatest gangster who ever lived. He personally wiped out the Wrath Cartel and the Vandal Helm Combine during the Syndicate Wars. When he died 10 years ago, Nock had more wealth than some Outer Rim worlds. Even the Huts were jealous.
Even the Huts? The Huts? Yes. Yes, it's the... Listen to the background music. Do we just got a little bit of Kakashic music from that great Jeremy Soul? Oh, sorry, girl. Were you talking to me? When he died? Shit. Wait a minute. It's destroyed listening to us. Okay. We died to him.
Is there a point to this?
So, where did all that wealth go? Yes, where did it go? That's where we're going, huh?
What happened to Nock's fortune after he died?
Now we're getting to the interesting part.
I figured.
Nock hid his fortune right before he died. For 10 years, treasure hunters across the galaxy have searched for it in vain. Until now. You see, I finally figured out how to get the lost riches of Nock Drayan.
Oh, you did, huh? Welcome to my ship.
You're my new best friend, Risha.
That's sweet. But let's try to keep this professional for now.
Oh, okay.
Whoever gets Nock's riches will become an underworld legend. Skavik had his chance and blew it. Now it's your turn. Help me deliver these things in your cargo hold, and Nocturne's wealth will be all yours.
Hold on, let me turn your volume down, girl. Some of your S sounds are overloading my speaker system and probably making people's eardrums explode. So maybe I would love to tell you, make your S's be a little bit less S'd. but I don't have the guts. Let me just turn you down one notch, all right? Just two notches. There we go. That's the sweet zone. All right, we're in the butter zone now. Well, what were you saying? All these deliver the things in our camera. Oh, it's that simple, is it? Really? Really? You're very trusting. Or perhaps I'm very trusting. Wait, that's weird. That something about that just sounds weird. And wrong. I don't know. Maybe it's just my mind is messed up. Well, it is, but still.
Oh, mine?
Some of you can have it too. I mean, you're helping me.
What are you getting out of this?
I'm after something personal. The money doesn't mean anything to me, Captain.
No, because you can get any time you want.
I'm the only one that can help you trade these items to get Nocturne's treasure. But I won't tell you everything up front. To get the riches, you trust me the same way I trust you. One step at a time. Deal?
Oh, no. I mean, you did work for Skavik. Something tells me you're not the one I'm looking for. Okay? Wait, whoa, whoa! I heard those footsteps, Corso. Back off, man. I got this one, all right?
You had me at riches.
Then let's hit the hyperlanes. We have deals set up on Taris and Nar Shaddaa. I'll make all the arrangements and introductions for you on both planets. Until then, I'll be in my bunk. That caged beast there isn't much good for conversation. So come visit me if you feel like chatting.
Okay. You got everything under control here? I'll be back often, don't worry. I'll make sure that caged beast doesn't do anything cagey, okay?
I'll be around for anything you need, sweetheart. Anything.
That's a comfort. Looking forward to working with you, Captain.
Likewise. But you're not the captain, though, so... Alright, finally we completed this stupid mission. Done. Did it. Boom! And we got Corso to love me even more, which is just weird now. I mean, it always was, but it's weird especially now. And we got this stupid blaster, which is, well, stupid. Or is it? No, it is. Let's be serious. It's even worse than my Outrunner's D-88 blaster pistol, which I got, like, years ago. Like, it feels like it's been years. I don't want any more of those things. It sucks. Get me the Plantae combination. I can actually use that. Complimentary minor experience boost. Yeah, I'll use that. Never. I'll use that. Whenever gets here. Whenever comes, I will use it. Until then, I'm gonna spit everywhere. Alright, thanks for watching this episode. I figured out how to find a place where I can jump. So, where I can actually... Whoa! Hey, check it out. I just figured out how to glitch through the floor, kind of like the way Gorsa did. There's a chance this could end up being bad. There's a chance this could end badly. I could, like, glitch through the floor and kill myself and never be able to come back here. But that's unlikely. Because I've got quick travel. Alright, thanks for watching. Goodbye. For now.